everyone, and welcome. My name is Sarah, and I work for California State Parks here in the beautiful Oceano Dunes District on the central coast of California. And I am joining you today from our beautiful Pismo State Beach Monarch Butterfly Grove. In today's video, we're going to learn all about migration. Now, what does that fancy word migration mean? And the answer is to move. So I need everybody watching this to move in order to remember that migration means to move. It's animals moving from one place to another. So think about it like this. Have you ever been on a vacation or maybe gone someplace other than your house or your home for a little while? Well, our monarchs do the same thing, and they do so to find warmer weather. They're always looking for warm weather. And the monarchs that we get here really like Pismo State Beach Monarch Butterfly Grove because it's a lot warmer than the other place they spend their time, which is all the way up in Canada. But before we talk more about where they come from and where they go, I want to talk about how they do it. Do you have any guesses on how monarchs know where to go? Now the answer are these guys. You might recognize these, and these are my antennae. Now the butterfly's antennae act like compasses and clocks, telling them where to go and when to do it. It's almost like magic. And other than those handy antennae, a few other things that tell the monarchs where to go and when to do it is a change in temperature. So when it gets colder or it gets warmer, they know it's time to move. Or a change in the length of a day. So did you know that in the summer, it gets much warmer, but the days also get a little longer? The sun goes down later? The monarchs know this and are able to use this information to move to the correct places when they need to. And just like I promised, it is now time to answer that question. Sarah, where in the world do the monarchs go when they're not with you here at Pismo State Beach? Now, in order to answer this, I'm going to use a map. So let's go ahead and check it out right now. Our story starts here in Pismo State Beach, where you see this palm tree and sun, and ends all the way up in Canada, where you see these snowflakes. Now, our butterflies will set out about February and have babies along the way, who will have more babies along the way to Canada, who will have more. And eventually, this happens 4 to 5 times until a really special type of butterfly called the super generation. That's why it has this cape here. We'll make it all the way back down from Canada to Pismo State Beach, Monarch Butterfly Grove. Now, when they arrive here at the grove after their long journey south, the super generation is tired, and that's why it's important they have safe places like our grove to rest in. Now, in a future video, we'll learn more about this, so go ahead and stay tuned for that. All right, kids, thank you so much for joining me today. I am truly so excited I got to talk to you about migration, or how and where the monarch butterflies move. That special word, migration, means to move, as you remember. But now you can tell your friends and your family that these little insects are able, with these wings, to make it all the way from Canada to us here at Pismo State Beach Monarch Butterfly Grove. That is an incredible fact. Now, something I want to leave you with, something I want you to remember, is that as humans, we have what I call an impact on nature and animals and plants and the environment. When I say we have an impact, it means that what you do matters. So I want to encourage you all to continue being the scientist that you are, learning as much about these animals, these insects, and how you can help them as possible. Thank you so much for joining me here, and I will see you next time.
To learn more, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on social media. Also, check out our Padlet.